Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. So today's video is something that I'm very excited to be presenting before you. In this video, I'll be showing you how we have set up certain Montessori spaces for our little one in our house in order to encourage independence, confidence and self-respect. These setups are very simple and they are nothing fancy. And all these spaces have been modified constantly over time to meet Arman's growing need of independence. So let's get started. We live in a two-bedroom apartment with Arman's grandparents. The living room is always occupied, so we set up Arman's play area in our bedroom, making it a bedroom-cum playroom. Ideally, a Montessori playroom is separated from the bedroom, and the bedroom usually has a very calm and relaxing atmosphere. But due to space constraints, we had to do this. So let's start with Arman's wardrobe. This is my husband's cupboard. We have dedicated two of its lowest drawers for Arman's clothing. One for the clothes he wears at home and the other for what he wears while going out. All of them are arranged in a way that makes it easy for him to choose what he wants. At this age, he clearly knows that some clothes are for home and some are supposed to be worn outside. So this arrangement works. Down here, he has stuff that he needs at home. T-shirts in one box, trousers in another, his pajamas or nightwears in another one here, underwears and kerchiefs here. His socks are here in a little basket. His comb. Earlier we used to have his comb kept in the washroom, but now this has become more convenient. His accessories like watches and belts are kept here in this basket as well. Here we have the clothes that he wears outside. His t-shirts in one box, shirts in another, trousers here. We have some party wears here in the box that lies behind and those are rarely used. He usually dresses up by himself without any help from my end. Now in here, we also have Arman's work shelf, which you might have seen in many of my previous videos. For those who are new here, this is where we set up all his activities and they are rotated depending on his interest and engagement. The shelf, as you can see, is of his height and every activity is visible to him and all of them are displayed in easy to carry baskets or trays. You will find more information on Montessori shelf setup in a previous video that I've done. I'll leave the link below in the description box. We have Arman's calendar here which he updates every day. This was a chocolate box we received as gift. We use it to store his calendar, cards and dates now. He can access it without my help and he knows most of the days by sight now. So he changes it mostly independently but sometimes with a little help from my end. For the video tutorial on this calendar, please check the description box. We also have Arman's chair and table here which is from IKEA that he uses both for his work and for having snacks. Now down here under my work table, we have attached a small hook to keep a dustpan and a small brush for him to clean up the mess after his activities. He collects and dumps the waste materials in this dustbin here. Over here we have his 5-layer shelf which has his art supplies. I'll hopefully show you the contents in details when I do a toy organization video in the future. One of the drawers is dedicated to storing his cleaning supplies. He has got a brush which he usually cleans his toys with, a sponge, a washcloth, a spray bottle and gloves. He uses them on a daily basis and he loves them more than his so-called toys. And on one side of his shelf, we have attached a hook to hang a small towel for him to wipe his hands and face whenever he wants to. He mostly uses it when he comes back from washroom or generally when his face or hands are wet. Now next I'll show you another hook we have attached here. Yes, we do have a lot of hooks due to space constraints. Here he hangs his clothes that can be worn again. For example, he hangs the clothes that he was wearing at home here when he changes to go out. Or if the dress he wears is not yet dirty enough to go to the laundry, he hangs it here. He usually asks me while changing if he has to hang it or put it in the laundry basket. We also keep this bottle of water and glass for him to easily get water without others' help. Earlier we had a dispenser which he could access as well, but now since that is gone, we switched to this system. To the kitchen. This is another place where Arman spends a lot of time. We have a step stool from IKEA that he uses to reach the counters. He sometimes uses this big stool here as well. He contributes to everything in the kitchen, be it washing the dishes, chopping vegetables, or making rotis. He loves them all. In fact, I have a rolling pin just for him as he loves rolling rotis beside me. This corner here serves as his little snack station. He gets his snacks by himself. He usually has fresh fruits or dry fruits like apricots, dates or nuts for snack, and occasionally cookies. As for the fruits, he gets them independently from the fridge, and the other things are stored here in these little jars which I keep refilling. I also store his snack bowls in the cabinet right below his snack station. This is our laundry room. We store our cleaning tools here as well. Arman has his little broom and mop here along with the other stuffs. He usually gets it from here by himself. In the living room, he has some open-ended toys like blocks and balls. He plays with them when we all spend time in the living room together. This is our shoe rack. One of the lowest racks is dedicated to Arman's shoes. He knows this is where his shoes go. In the bathroom, we keep a basket next to the sink to store his toothbrush and other stuff so that he can access them easily. He has a step stool that he uses to reach the sink and also to get onto the toilet seat. We store his toilet seat right here on a little hook. He has been independently using the toilet for a long time now. In the bathroom, breaking things down into steps they can easily follow is the main key. They find it easier when there is an order to things. So these are some ways in which we have incorporated Montessori in our house as a family. As I said earlier, it's nothing fancy and this is what works the best for us at the moment. I hope at least some of you found this video helpful. If so, please don't forget to click the like button and share it with your friends and family. And if you're new here and you like the video, don't forget to click the subscribe button. Thanks for watching. What are you making, Arman?
Chicken sandwich.
Chicken sandwich? Yes. Oh. Will you give me your sandwich?
It's going to be empty.
Yes. Nah. Да. Yes. Mm.